Welcome to Module 5, Part 5. In this section, we are going to check a new topic, that is integrated circuits. Integrated circuits, or ICs, allow complex circuits consisting of millions of transistors, diodes, and resistors and capacitors to be included in a single chip. Earlier, vacuum tubes were being used to build the electronic devices, but because of its complexity, they were replaced with transistors. Transistors offered more flexibility, convenience, and reliability than the vacuum tubes. Integrated circuits, or ICs, enable new application for electronics, which is not possible with discrete components. Sophisticated circuitry can be minimized for use in space vehicles, computers, and all the electronic devices where the discrete component use is impractical. Moving on to the advantages of integrated circuits. As you all know, ICs offer miniaturization. Cost reduction is offered by simultaneously fabrication of many ICs on a single silicon wafer called batch fabrication. Reliability also increases in such fabrication process. Although the processing steps for the wafers are complex and expensive, the larger number of ICs cost is reduced. Large-scale integration of many circuits on a single silicon chip has led to major reduction in computer size, thereby increasing in speed and functional density. Decrease in signal transfer time integration can reduce parasitic capacitance and inductance between the circuits. Reduction of parasites can provide significant improvement in operating speed. Faulty devices occur because of some defects in the silicon wafer or fabrication steps. Reducing the number of devices greatly increases the chance of the given device to be free of defects. Therefore, the percentage of yield of usable circuits increases over a certain range of decreasing chip area. So these are the different advantages of the integrated circuits. Next, moving on to the types of integrated circuits. There are basically two types of integrated circuits. One based on the application and the second one based on the fabrication. According to the applications, there are two types. One is the linear IC and the second one is the digital IC. According to the fabrication, there are two types. One is monolithic ICs and the second one is hybrid IC. Moving on to the details of this, linear ICs perform applications or other essential linear operations on signals. Example, amplifiers, op-amps, analog communication circuits. So these are all the linear ICs. Digital ICs are used in applications like computer, calculators and microprocessors. Digital ICs are less stringent than the linear ICs, and digital ICs are even less complex than the linear ICs. Integration of IC on a single chip of semiconductor is called as monolithic circuits. Hybrid circuits may contain one or more monolithic circuits or individual transistors bonded to an insulating substrate with resistors, capacitors, and other circuit elements, together with appropriate interconnections. Hybrid circuits have excellent isolation between the components and allow the use of more precise resistors and capacitors. Whereas monolithic circuits have the advantage that all the components are contained in a single rigid structure. Hundreds of identical circuits can be built simultaneously on a single wafer. So these are the different types of integration. One based on the application and second one based on the fabrication. Next, moving on to the evolution of integrated circuits. IC was first invented by Jack Kilby on February 1959 at Texas Instruments. The planar version, that is the using the layers of ICs, was developed by Robert Noyce in July 1959 at Fairchild. Since then, the technology has been growing extremely fast. Figure over here shows the number of transistors used in the MOS microprocessor IC chips over the time. So in the x-axis, it is the time, and y-axis are the number of transistors per chip. So you can observe that it is a straight line, which indicates that there is exponential growth in the complexity of the chips. The component count has roughly doubled every 18 months, as stated by Jordan Moore of Intel Corporation. And this came to be known as Moore's Law, which states that the number of transistors double in every 18 months, which means every 18 months, the number of transistors integrated on a single chip will double. Depending upon the components count, we have different eras of integrated circuits. So over here, you can see SSI, which stands for small scale integration. Then we have medium scale integration, large scale integration, very large scale integration, ultra large scale integration. So GSI stands for giant scale integration. In small scale integration, around 1 to 100 devices are integrated on a single chip. Devices over here is the transistors. In medium scale integration, around 100 to 1000 devices are integrated on a single chip. That was in the year 1970. Small scale integration evolved in the year 1960. Then came the large scale integration, where around 1000 to 10 lakh transistors were integrated on a single chip. Then in around 1980 to 1990 came the VLSI, very large scale integration. Then in 2000 we have ultra large scale integration. So the number of devices integrated are in somewhere in between 10 lakh to 1 billion devices, that is 100 crores. So the next would be giant scale integration, or RLSI, ridiculously large scale integration. The main factor that has led to the increase in complexity is the ability to shrink the devices. Scaling requires tremendous technological challenges in lithography, etching, doping, gate dielectric, and metallization. So these are all the fabrication steps which we have already studied. Small features and a large feature requires device fabrication in extremely clean environment. So that we have already seen. So the microprocessor in the year 1970 had around 100 to 1000 devices. So you can see here 10 raised to 3. Then we had Pentium in the year somewhere around 1990 to 2000. So it had 10 raised to 6 transistors. Then the Xeon processors, which have around 10 raised to 8 transistors on a single chip. So this is how the evolution of IC took place. Thank you.